Welcome back to my favorite tarot books and also tarot companion books for 2016. And if you can see this here behind me, I still have my Christmas tree. I call it more my Yule tree up because for me, Yule is reaching out till I guess I will remove the tree or at least the decoration around the 20th or so of January. But that's the fine thing about celebrating Yule. I stretch the season much longer. Okay, I also have the benefit of the Christmas season before, but the Yule season is very important to me also. I know as a kid I hated, really, I hated removing the Christmas decorations about the around the 6th of January or so, sometimes a bit before. I hated it when I was always sad and so on, and I hated January because it was so dull. But now I reach or I stretch it out until mid-January until I feel the time is the time is over, and I can step into the season of Imbolc or of Candlemas. So you will still see this one here behind me in this video. So I will start with my favorite tarot books. I divided it in tarot books and tarot companion books. So for my favorite tarot books, I have only four, if I see it correctly, and a bit more for my sixth one for my favorite companion books, tarot companion books. So I will start with the big and heavy ones. I will start with the top one, with the one that everyone has, every good tarot reader has, and I only jumped on board last year in, I guess, in the early spring or so, or late spring, I'm not sure. Of course, Holistic Tarot. This is a bunch of a book, and this is, of course, for me, not necessarily a reference book, but a study book, and there are a lot of things here put in here, where I go back and forth and back and forth and so on. And this is really worth a depth deep study. Still, I can't talk. I talk too much today. Ah, yeah, who would guess that after these tremendous amount of videos I try to pull off and they hadn't worked really. So this is an in-depth study book, really a resource to have, and what a bunch of tarot knowledge. And it's really helpful to go in deeper, and it's a return to resource. I guess you wouldn't, I guess in every at every stage you can need this book. This is really, it is definitely not necessarily a beginner's book. I wouldn't, this is something I said, maybe I said this before, I'm not quite sure. This is not necessarily a book I would recommend for a total beginner because it could be too overwhelming. So, but it is something when you have a bit more comfortable with the cards, this is something you can't miss, actually. So, but a book that is more for the beginner, and I know this is this book is not I won't say it's not popular, but some people don't like it that much or see it as more of a coffee table book or something like that. I heard that term. And it's Tarot Fundamentals by Los Carrabillo, the big one. I know there is the second one. I'm not quite sure if I want to get it. I hope that there is maybe a flip through or something like that soon because I would like to dive into it. I like this book anyway because it's a great reference book. This is something, okay, it's a bit too heavy for a simple reference book, but I like it. I like that there are different cards in there, card representations of the of Los Carrabillo decks. I know this is something that some people really piss off because they think that this is just an advertising deck for Los Carrabillo. I still love it. I like that there are lessons included for each of the cards here. For the majors, there's also something like the voice of the major card. I try to find that. Something like that. When judgment, for instance, when judgment speaks to you, I am the sign that your life has changed. You are transforming. There is no going back now. The road has crumbled behind you. Embrace me. even if I feel uncomfortable. Change often invokes vulnerability. Heeding my call, you rise to new heights. Do not look down and have no fear. You are safe. You are brilliant. You are reborn. And this is something I really, really appreciate about this deck. I still like it. I'm still happy that I bought it. Let's put it like this. And there's also a lot of historical reference in the background of the book. And it's okay. I like it. I have another book that I try to figure out where I put it. But I will find it. Ah, there it is. Haha. This is this book here. This is the German edition, and it's not known by this cover. It's by Cynthia Giles, and the original title is Tarot, History, Mystery, and Law. I know that Nobody's Here had a little, not necessarily a review, but in one of her videos she mentioned that book and shows this book. This is more basically the history of tarot, but it is a fascinating, fascinating book to delve into and go into, and I like this very much. So now we go into a more fun, creative way of using tarot cards. And the first one was this book that I got, The Creative Tarot. This popped up quite a lot. This is by Jessa Crispin, A Modern Guide to an Inspired Life. I thought it's bit more different than than when I read it. I thought this would be more an active book, some kind of a workbook or something like that. But it's a bit like a reference book, so it goes through the minors and the majors, and takes the meanings of those cards and similarities in history, in novels, in films, in movies, how you want to call it, in a theater place, and so on. And you get references at the back of each of the cards for further study. Something like here for the Three of Cups, they have, for instance, a book by Mary McCarthy, Between Friends, The Correspondence of Hannah Arendt and Mary McCarthy. Then we have The Mitfords, Letters Between Six Sisters, book edited by Charlotte Mosley, and The Women, film directed by George Cukor. And this is something you find for everyone, for every card, not everyone. Like I said, I thought it would be more of a workbook, but still it is a very, very usable, very readable book, and it certainly deepens the meanings of certain cards, of every card in the tarot, and brings it to another level, maybe to a more approachable level. And it is interesting to delve into this. There's also some colorful representations of, I guess it's the deck that she created herself out of collages and so on. So it is very, very in depth for that purpose. But like I said, it's not necessarily a book that helps you to work with your creativity in terms of practical exercises or so. But still a very usable book. Sorry. Another book that is a workbook, actually, is, like the title would give it away, The Tarot Activity Book by Andy Matzner, or Metzner. I'm not sure how you pronounce it in English. And the second title is A Collection of Creative and Therapeutic Ideas for the Cards. And this is really cool. You get a lot of things, something like, for instance, Tarot Haiku. To use tarot cards as inspiration for a Japanese style of poetry, and so on and so forth. And you choose cards. There is a funny little exercise at the beginning. I try to find it, where they suggest. So you have a birthday party. Which tarot majors would you like to invite, and why, and so on. There are a lot of nice little things for journaling. So if this is a journaling tarot book, I try to find another one. Okay, this is mostly it is I try to find something which mind here. This is interesting, the inner child dialogues. So there are some it's always split into this one. So you have this objective background and then objective background and process, how to process this exercise. Objective, it says to meet and communicate with different aspects of yourself. And background, the term inner child generally refers to the part of our psyche, or psyche in your case, that continues to retain memories and feelings originally experienced during childhood. Each person, however, usually has more than one inner child, each which exists as an independent entity. These aspects of ourselves can be either easily accessible or deeply buried. Here are some examples of inner children: the playful children, the creative, the spoiled, the neglected, the fearful, the wounded, or the invalided or invalided child. Inner child work is typically connected to exploring our needs, both past and present. But what are needs, and why are they important, and so on and so forth. So these go through, and then it goes through questions like who are you, how old are you, where are you, and so on and so forth. I've tried to find. So go through the tarot deck and choose one or more cards that you feel best represent yourself as a child. If you like, choose different cards that match up with various ages and states of being. For example, one card might be you as a 3-year-old or playful child, another as a 10-year-old neglected child, and yet another as a teenager. When you have collected your cards, take out your journal, as you'll be doing writing during this exercise. Take some time to settle in and get into a comfortable position where you won't be disturbed. Then, for each card, write down each of the following questions in your journal on separate pages without answering them. You will be asking these questions as your adult self, and so on. And then you have these questions here at the bottom. A lot of things to delve into, to use your cards. This is really a book to be playful with your cards, and also have tremendous help from the journaling process. Healing book, very, very, very good. Another book that I just recently purchased, and I'm not sure if I mentioned it before. I just posted it on my Instagram and on Facebook. Was by Alison Cross, who did also A Year in the Wildwood, and this is called the Kaizen Tarot. This is a book that is perfect for the tarot collector, for those who have a lot of tarot decks, especially tarot decks that they bought and then never used, or almost not or almost not using. And this is a book full of exercises to approach your decks, to get the most out of your decks. It requires, when I remember correctly, a Smith-Waite based deck, so to speak. I'm not sure if this will work with other decks, but I'm quite sure you can try it. But at least you should do it with one deck, because otherwise you wouldn't go into deep with this deck, of course. So the other books that I would like to share with you, okay, obviously this one has to go on this list also, Rachel Pollack, The 78 Degrees of Wisdom, in German it's called 78 Stufen der Weisheit. This is something I got secondhand, and I'm quite happy to have it. Well,
Also,
back again. This day is really we would say in German, verhext. For some reason, I have really problems to record videos or record videos or make videos. So I guess the universe wants to tell me something. I should focus on other things. But now I want to finish it. I want to do it. And I want to share with you my favorite stack here, my favorite companion books. So, whoop, let's see with which. Will I start? Okay, I will start with this one. Obviously, I had it as my favorite tarot deck last year, and this is also one of my favorite companion books. The Mary L. Tell companion book, or Landscapes of the Abyss. I like that there is another kind of title for it. And this is really, sometimes it's really interesting because some cards are really more in depth, more explained, more deeply explained. Some are quite short. This is something I don't like always, but still I like it and I still need it for some reason because there is a lot to take from, because there's so much things going on. There's a lot of things going on from the Tree of Life and so on and so forth. So I'm not quite familiar with that one, but it's worth it, and it's good to get the most out of the Mary L. Tarot. Good book. Another one where a lot of people waited for because this deck was so unusual, is the Chrysalis Tarot. This is a deck that I for some reason missed to put on the list of my favorite decks, because I only worked with it in the spring month for a certain period of time, but it is in one of my boxes, so it was quite tucked away. But this is a gorgeous, gorgeous book, and it helps you to delve deeper into the Chrysalis universe. Some people can't really read with it. I'm not sure if I would have kept it longer. I'm not quite sure. But this one is really, I like to approach this deck a bit more with that. And I really also like that there are more depictions or alternate depictions of certain cards. That there are certain groups that are important in this deck. I really love this picture here, this of Papa Lechba, and I'm not quite sure with whom. I guess it's Ariadne, with whom he is getting in contact with in this deck. She is deaf, and I really like that. What's interesting also is that the black and white representation of the cards are mostly drafts for the specific card that is the topic on the page, and sometimes they're quite the same, and sometimes they're a bit different. I'm not quite sure. I guess this one is different here, the Five of Stones, but nonetheless a very good book and very worth reading it and delve into the Chrysalis with this one. The next book, which would I like to, this one, this is the Margaret Peterson, you could say companion book in some degree, but it's, to me, it's much more. It's it bends the rules, should I say the rules, I'm not sure, the rules of companion books. It gives you the traditional meanings of at least of the minors, at least of the majors, but it's not the typical companion book that you would have, because if you remember, those of you who have the little white book of the Margaret Peterson, she describes her major arcana cards in poems. And this is something she takes much more beyond in this book. So there are a lot of more poems, but there are also the general meanings for the cards. But what you have is, I try to find a very good representation. Let's see which we have here, like this one. You have full colored representation of the cards, and you have these kinds of poems. You could say poems. It's a bit like experimental writing, you could say. It's something to meditate with. It's not in a usual companion book, like I said before. I know. This is a long day. And I really like that you can see so much more details in this bigger book, and can really dive into it. And it's simply gorgeous, and I'm quite happy to have it. Like I said, the minors are not necessarily, there are not the typical meanings of it, like here for the Ace of Coins. You have also some kind of poems here at the site. I would like to translate it 101 for you right now, but I talk that much today that I have no much brain space. And it's got darker and darker in here. Yeah, can see how long I'm. Yeah, you will see these videos probably day after day after day. But this is really, you can see the clothes here. This is one major shot, actually. I will make a little pause because I want to make more light in here. So back again with a little bit more of daylight, or the rest of the daylight. I will continue with companion books, and will continue with this one. This is the newest one I got. This is the companion book for the Mythic Terror, which is in German. It's the Delphische Tarot. The Delphische Tarot, das Delphische Tarot. And you can get this German book only separately at the moment, secondhand. There was a big set, I guess, a big set with also cloth and something like that, also in English. But I quite like this, and I like that the pages are so, look so old, and it smells like old books, this kind of sweet paper smell from old books, which I really love. And this is a really good book also as a reference, although this is more specifically to the myths of old Greece, but still there's a lot things that you can draw from this too. And I like the mythology that there is for all the cards, is the mythology, the history, or the story, the mythic story behind the cards. And this is really something I really enjoy. And I like that I finally found a German book, actually, German companion books, quite a nice thing to read, tarot related stuff in German also. So gorgeous book. So another one which I really love, and this is the Dreams of Gaia tarot companion book for the set. And I'm in awe of this work that Raven Phelan was doing with the creation of this deck. I enjoy it so much that for each of the cards you have these keywords and then also key phrases, which helps you to dive in quickly if you want to. But if you want to get deeper into, you get really much out of the cards, sometimes really several pages. For the majors, you have present, past, and future aspects, and also potential blockage references and so on. It's deep, it's powerful, and I'm looking forward to learn much more from this book and with this deck. So, and the last one, it's really one of my favorite tarot companion books at the moment. And yeah, I know you will hate me, probably hate me. The Gaian Tarot, and I have the book, the Schiffer book, and this is the only thing from the Schiffer edition I'm using, actually. I'm quite happy with this one. I'm not necessarily overly fond of the kind of a graphic thing going on here. This reminds me of a school book or something. So my English books look always like this in school, visually. And this is not necessarily which something I feel is related to this earth-based deck. So I have seen how the other companion books, either in the Llewellyn edition or in the original edition from the not mass ma ma mass market produced one, in the independent produced version, how this looks. You know, I really talk a long time today. I hope you can, you can take something from this video at all. Sorry. I know now, universe, I know it. Next time I will do something else instead of trying to force it. Still, this book, good companion book. I love it. I love that it goes so into the details of the symbolism, especially in the majors. The minors are a little bit more neglected. There are affirmations for the majors. For the minors, you have also affirmations and shadow meanings and so reverse meanings and upright meanings. And as I said, genre questions. Like for instance, for the, let's see, which deck we have, the Hermit, for instance. Questions like when was the last time, if ever, I spent a full day and night alone? Or how can I get away from everyday life to spend time alone? Where can I go on retreat? What are the elements of a great retreat? How do I feel about being alone? What are the riches I find in solitude? How do I feel about the aging process? What lessons do the spirit animals have for me? Am I ready to return to the world to share my light and knowledge? What kind of feeling does the hermit offer me? What kind of feeling can I offer the earth through the example of the hermit? And the affirmation is, I retreat from the world in order to refresh my spirit. And I really love, love, love that. And this really was the book made me fall in love with the rest of the deck. And yeah, the rest is history. So, I guess I now have done everything from favorite tarot to favorite oracle to favorite tarot books and so on. My wish list, this is something that I still haven't done. I'm not sure if I'll make a separate video at the moment. The wish list is, yeah, could I say short? Sometimes it's short, sometimes it's longer. There are decks that are coming on and off and so on. Decks that I thought I would purchase much earlier and I still haven't purchased it because of the time and shipping costs and so on. Timing in terms of shipping process. Sometimes it takes a long, long way to, yeah, to ship here to Germany. And like I said, the costs are sometimes outrageously high. I know it's not so easy, but and sometimes you have the advantage to get them. You have a tracking number and so on, and but still, my money at the moment is a bit. I'm a bit on a budget now, so I have really to search really wisely which deck I really want, and if there isn't already something in my collection that is isn't or is worth spending the time elsewhere. So if you know what I mean, really at the moment I have no clue what I'm talking anymore. I have a lot of German English mix in my head. This is the reason probably that a lot of stuff here in the video is so convoluted or so. So I will stop it now and will try to upload these videos within the next days. I guess the first you will already have seen, and you will see the decay from video to video. So I hope you have a wonderful day and a peaceful night. So see us very soon. Bye.